Saul Alvarez, 37-0, with a draw, 27 knockouts from Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico. Both fighters are from Guadalajara. This kid's an interesting guy. He turned pro in October of 2005 with a fourth-round TKO win over Abraham Gonzalez in Jalisco. And he KO'd 11 of his first 13 opponents. And Dave, he's had some interesting victories as well. In May of 10, he stopped Jose Miguel Cotto in Las Vegas. In September, he stopped Carlos Baldomir. In December of 10, he defeated Lovemore Ndu, who's watching in Australia. March this year, he won a 12-round victory over Matthew Hatton, Ricky Hatton's younger brother. And he won his world title over Ryan Rhodes last time out.
He's been on a good roll. He really has grown significantly in stature over the last couple of years. We'd heard all the drumbeats about what was expected of him, and now those expectations are being fulfilled, maybe even a little bit on the early side.
Well, he's just 21 years of age. That's another thing that you forget. This kid is very, very popular, not just by the Mexican fight fans, by, as you mentioned, the Irish fight fans. They all thought he was Irish because of the red hair.
You better believe it. What a great international thing for him to expand his audience. And just a natural, nice guy. He's even gotten into the promotional ranks on some of the Golden Boy telecasts. So this is a guy with an incredible tailwind promotionally and from a marketing standpoint to go with his considerable boxing ability.
Well, if he wins this WBC Super Welterweight Championship defense against Gomez, it's unfortunate he doesn't speak any English because his marketability will really soar on this stage with a huge pay-per-view buy. Now, remember we told you that Jim Lampley from HBO in the United States will be calling this fight live because Dave and I are actually in the arena here in Las Vegas, and we'll be calling what we see, and Lampley will be calling it for the audience that's in attendance here. This is the scene in Las Vegas. Saul Alvarez and Alfonso Gomez for the WBC Super Welterweight title. Wayne Hedgepeth will be the referee. The ring announcer over there is Joe Martinez, and this fight is about to get underway. Alejandro Rochin, Ray Corona, and Samuel Conde will be the judges of this fight. The tail of the tape will tell you a few things. Alvarez, an inch shorter, a pound heavier, 9 years younger, 2 inches advantage in reach.
And the rules, no three knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. You go to the scorecards at the end of round four in the case of an accidental butt, and a fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round.
So the stage is just about set. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Staples Center here in the sports capital of the world, Los Angeles, California. Mayweather Promotions and Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions in association with Canelo Promotions present to you the main event of the evening. Una guerra entre dos tapatíos. 12 rounds scheduled for the WBC Super Welterweight Championship of the World. Sponsored by Tecate, Cerveza con Carácter, DeWalt Power Tools, new 20-volt max lithium ion system, AT&T, get it faster with 4G, rethink possible, Southwest Airlines, fly Southwest, it's the right call, and Cancun Tourism, Cancun, discover paradise. Sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission, the chairman, John Frierson, executive officer, George Dobb. Physicians at ringside, Dr. Leandro Gattus and Dr. Blair Cranston. Your timekeepers in charge of the bell and counting for knockdowns, Willie Arriola and John Lechting. WBC supervisor in attendance, Mike George. Your three judges scoring this bout on the 10-point must system at ringside. From California, Max DeLuca. From California, Ray Corona. And from Mexico, Alejandro Rochin. When the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action from California, Wayne Hedgman. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the judges are ready and the fighters are ready. Los peleadores están listos. Ciudad de Los Ángeles, Dile al Mundo. Make some noise if you are ready. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing white trunks trim and the flag of Mexico, green, white, and red. Official weight, 152 and 1.5 pounds. As a professional, his record is outstanding. 23 victories, 4 defeats with 2 draws and 12 wins coming by way of knockout. De Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, El Retador, the challenger, Alfonso Gomez. And next is the opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner. Wearing gold trunks with red and green trim, he weighed in 153 and 1.5 pounds. As a young professional, he enters the ring perfect. 37 victories, no defeats, 1 draw, 27 wins by way of knockout. De Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, the reigning, defending, undefeated WBC Super Welterweight Champion of the World, Saúl Canelo Álvarez.
Good evening, gentlemen. This is for the WBC Championship. You good here? You got your instructions in the dressing room? Obey my commands at all times. Above all, protect yourself. Touch him up and come out the bell.
All right, Dave, so we see a nice crowd in attendance over at the Staples Center, about 150 miles from Las Vegas in Los Angeles. Alfonso Gomez, decked out in the white trunks with the multicolored Mexico flag. He's to the bottom of your screen to the left with his back to you right now. And in the gold trunks is Saúl Álvarez. Álvarez, the reigning champ. Alfonso Gomez.
Eventually, we would figure that Gomez is going to try to come at Álvarez. And then Álvarez can move side to side and try to do his damage there.
Álvarez doing a lot of waiting right now. Gomez only has 12 knockouts in his 23 victories, so he's not considered a very big puncher. And Álvarez, on the other hand, has 27 knockouts in his 37 victories, so he can bang a bit.
And, you know, for Álvarez, the stakes keep going up every fight. He's in front of a huge live audience. He's fighting just before Floyd Mayweather, a huge worldwide stage. And, you know, he's right in the middle of it here.
Álvarez, 37-0 with a draw. And you hear them in Los Angeles chanting, Canelo. And that's the nickname of Saúl Álvarez, Canelo. Or in English, Canelo. You know, he doesn't seem too aggressive here. He's kind of feeling out Alfonso Gomez in the first round.
He takes a left hook. And then I think some of the butterflies might be there. Yeah, until he can loosen up a little bit. This is all a big deal. It's the biggest stage ever. And he needs a little time to settle into his attack.
Gomez gets off his combination, tries to get the jab in the face of Canelo. Saúl Álvarez doing a lot of waiting through the first couple of minutes here. And you might be right, a a little tentativeness on his side, but now he picks it up a bit, gets a nice jab through them, the combination. Wild with the left hand goes Alfonso Gomez. Gomez to the left of your screen. Canelo with the red hair and the gold trunks. Alvarez is a farm boy from Jalisco. Loves to ride his horse. Anybody that likes horses, I like. And I know you with the nickname of Pony Boy.
Man after our own heart right there. And I think that in the second round, you should see a different look from Alvarez.
Well, it's clear. Oh, look at that. There's a shot and there's the power. And down goes Alfonso Gomez. He right back up.
We may not have to wait that long.
Yeah. Takes the standing eight count from Wayne Hitchpeth. And the bell ends at round number one. So, you know, Alvarez was cruising along, and I was thinking of giving that round to Alfonso Gomez. All of a sudden, it turns around completely, and Alvarez gets a 10-8 round. Here we go, round number two. Saul Alvarez, the champion in his first title defense, decked out the gold and white trunks with the black shoes and the red hair. Gomez, who made his bones on the reality show The Contender, very popular fighter, but nowhere near, I would think, of the popularity of Saul Alvarez continues to rise. Alvarez, for all the aggressiveness of Gomez in the first round, he ends up winning the first round, so whatever his game plan is, it's working now.
I mean, that could be a 3-point turnaround. If you're going to give him the round 10-9 to Gomez, and then you go 10-8 to Alvarez, then that little situation there is worth 3 points. The huge swing in favor of Alvarez.
Alvarez still continues to take his time as Gomez comes through. And Dave, you said Gomez's best shot in this is to just let it fly and go all out in the early going of this fight. That appears to, I mean, he was on his way to winning the first round, I thought. But every time that he catches up with Alvarez, Alvarez gets that adrenaline flow and counters him very, very well and looks to be much more powerful than Gomez.
But Gomez has had more straight-ahead type fights that I've seen, and Alvarez has shown more lateral movement and getting some good power off of that movement.
Some very good sportsmanship there by Alvarez. He had Gomez with his back to him, and he could have wailed him to the side of the head, but he let himself Gomez turn all the way around before he started boxing again. And had he hit him, it wouldn't have been an illegal punch. What is illegal is to turn your back on your opponent, which Gomez did.
Yeah, that was a nice move by Alvarez.
Left hook, chopping right hand, the side of the head. 2 minutes gone here in round number two from the Staples Center in Los Angeles. Saul Alvarez defending his title for the first time and apparently doing a pretty good job of it so far.
No pushing, no pushing, no pushing.
Well, you can hear the popularity of Alvarez as you hear them chanting in Los Angeles, Canelo, Canelo.
He's a cult hero.
And again, he's only 21 years of age, and the fans really, really like him. Because a lot of Mexicans came up from the Tijuana area to Los Angeles to see him fight as well in Los Angeles. Mexican Independence Day. All right, the bell ends the second round. I think Alvarez's round as well.
Hay que pintar un poquito, y fue porque es lento. Hay que pintar a ver qué hace. Hay que pintar, hay que amagar, no hay que ir nada más así. Hay que mover la cintura poquito y pintarlo y rectearlo. Rectearlo, se te deja venir un pasito atrás aquí. Aquí, pues, aquí. Aquí, aquí, aquí. Pum, aquí. Sin hacer confianza, y pues. Y mucho recto. Déjelo corto. Vámonos.
All right, we're coming up to round number three. Alvarez actually won his title from Hatton and then defended against Brian Rose. So in reality, I think I said this was his first title defense. It's his second title defense because he won his title 2 fights ago from Hatton's younger brother. All right, this is round three. And he looks like he's well on his way to defending his title again. But it's early yet. Afonso Gomez trying to force the fight, as Dave said he must.
He's trying to slip inside the jab and come in on Alvarez. And he has to maximize every chance when he gets close. He's having a hard time cutting off the ring here. He needs to take a quick step to his right and get to that spot ahead of Alvarez.
Afonso Gomez looks like he has a bit of a cut by his left eye, and the action opens up. And Alvarez, every time he gets hit, he explodes. A minute gone here. Nice movement by Alvarez. Now we get this view and see if we can see that cut by the left eye, I believe, of Alfonso.
Let him out.
Pulls him down. Alfonso does with that elbow.
The uppercut would have been a better idea for him there.
Absolutely.
The jab hand of Alvarez plus the shoulder rubbing into that eye area may be spelling some trouble for Gomez.
The chant continues. Canelo, Canelo. Those left hooks were taken on the elbow of Canelo Alvarez. Alvarez doing about what he wants here. He's dictating the flow in this fight. Although Afonso Gomez is trying to force the fight as much as he can. But that's his only shot at winning this thing. He's got to force the fight.
And that's been the story of his career. Take your shots. Yeah, he was unheralded before the contender. Underdog against Gatti. He's been in a lot of fights where nobody expected much. So, why not just go for it?
Seconds to go in round three of the scheduled 12-rounder. Heavier blows continue to be landed by Saul Alvarez. Nice uppercut. Can't take anything away from Gomez for hustle. This is the scene. We showed you the wide shot as it is here in Las Vegas. And that's no knockdown. This is round four in Los Angeles.
Don't push him down.
In the white trunks is Afonso Gomez. In the gold is Alvarez. There was a knockdown of sorts in the first round when we had a chance to look at the replay. We question whether there was a punch behind it. It doesn't appear that it's going to be a major factor because, in reality, Alvarez is taking this guy to school. And as I say that, I'm not taking anything away from Gomez because he's battling hard right now.
Yeah, he's really getting on the inside and trying to wage this battle. Being close and letting his hands go. Oh, that uppercut from Alvarez. Be aware of that on the inside. That was sneaky.
Gomez actually having a very good first minute of this fourth round and approaching the halfway point. He may steal this round, and he needs to. He's got to start putting some rounds in the bank before it gets too much further along. Now, Alvarez is on the ropes because that's where he wants to be. As he comes with uppercuts, then he opens up a little bit. Now the jab, wild with the uppercut. All the time, tap, tap, tap in the face by Gomez. And the chopping right hand. Gomez can still win this round.
Hey, if you're Gomez and you think you've done a good job in the round, you can back off a little bit here. Yeah, you put the pressure on, take Alvarez out of his comfort zone.
I don't think, Dave, that when Alvarez is in the ring, that there is any zone that isn't comfortable to him. He's that kind of fighter.
And he's been quite prolific, but in his last two fights, we're seeing more lengthier fights from him. He tries to pile up points. So, always you try to stay in the fight.
Yeah, well, with Matthew Hatton, a different thing, trying to win the title and then winning the title, and then in his first title defense against Ryan Rhodes, it took a while, 12 rounds it was scheduled for. And the crowd in attendance in Los Angeles loves it. And the crowd in Las Vegas getting into it as well. Valens the fourth round. I got to give that to Gomez.
I think so.
This is round five in the Staples Center in Los Angeles. Alvarez may have dropped that last round, but he's still in front in the fight. Alfonso had his best round of the fight in the fourth round. I think he won it. It's very difficult to tell from calling it on the monitor how heavy the punches are. And oftentimes that makes a difference because I know that Alvarez is much heavier handed.
Gomez continues to cooperate stylistically for Alvarez. He may walk into an uppercut.
Alvarez just looks so totally relaxed, almost too relaxed. And look at Gomez. In reality, you know, Dave, Alfonso Gomez is a bit of a step up in class for Saul Alvarez, too.
Well, you know, based on the fighters he's been in against.
Yeah, Gomez certainly isn't wilting against this guy. He shows no fear whatsoever.
Coming straight at him.
He's trying to do everything he can do. He knew he had to start fast. And even though he gave Alvarez, you know, the first three rounds, Gomez is having another real decent first half of this fifth round and is crawling back into the fight.
He's starting to duck the head, get inside, and fire shots. And there's going to be some point in this fight where they're each going to throw a big punch at the same time, and somebody's going to win that battle big. And they're launching some good shots.
With a minute to go, Alvarez better pick it up, or he's going to let this round slip away, and he does. They exchange jabs. Alvarez is supposed to be an inch shorter than Gomez, and he looks like he's about an inch and a half taller.
He's using his jab well to do that. There was a good uppercut by Alvarez.
And a good solid shot that time, too. Now, this is one of the rounds, Dave, that we're going to have to rely on the judges in California to call that, because what looked like some pretty heavy punches off the hands of Alvarez could be the difference in this round. I mean, Gomez is pressuring him, but we talked about effective aggressiveness. Closing seconds now of the fifth. I have to mark that on my score sheet as even. The judges won't do that, but I really can't give you any indication because I don't know how heavy those punches were. Boy, is he totally confident and relaxed there.
Just another day at the office for him. But Gomez is doing a nice job bringing some fight out of him, pressing him, helping him look good.
Now we can see by the look in the corner that Alfonso Gomez may just have abrasions around the eyes. It doesn't look like he's cut. I thought back in the first and second round he might have been cut, but he's not. This is round six from the Staples Center in Los Angeles, California, in the USA. Alfonso. Alfonso Gomez trying to lift the WBC Super Welterweight Championship at 154 pounds from the reigning champ, Saul Alvarez. Alvarez with the red hair and the gold trunks, and in the white trunks is Alfonso Gomez.
Well, a little grist for the mill here. Both fighters have landed 81 punches exactly through five rounds. And Alvarez, actually, Gomez has thrown about 70 more punches. So that looks good. That means what happened at the end of round one looms larger and larger. That huge turnaround for Alvarez with that knockdown.
Of course, the judges don't have the punch stat. And for them to judge the round, they're looking at, you know, how heavy and how punishing. It's different than the amateurs where, you know, sometimes the accumulation of punches is much more important. But in the professional ranks, the heavier punches oftentimes will swing the round, especially when the other guy's throwing more. But if you land heavier punches, it's the hurt business in professional boxing.
And what's interesting, I mean, you could make the argument that maybe Gomez won two of the five rounds, which would put him in it. But then that knockdown at the end of round one is a huge turnaround, and he's way in the hole.
Yeah, I mean, certainly two and three were close. And as a matter of fact, five was close. So, I mean, he's in the fight. Alvarez still looks to me like he's waiting to open it up, Dave. You know, he's only opened it up a couple of times. He looks like any time he wants, he could explode, really put some hurt on Alfonso Gomez. And Gomez is working as hard as he can, obviously, to accumulate more punches than Saul.
And we've seen this in other fights. And in the last one, similar type of a style, but all of a sudden he exploded and the fight was over. In the meantime, he's trying to pile up points.
Well, he may or may not be doing that. It depends on how the judges see the aggressiveness of Alfonso Gomez. But at some stage, he's got a... Oh, that's a big shot. That hurt him.
Here's your stage.
He may have him in trouble. That's three unanswered punches. Four, five, six, seven.
He could end it.
It's all over. Gomez is not happy, but as you said, he can explode at any time.
Just like in his last fight, a sudden barrage and the fight was over. And that's what happens here. Uppercut starts it. Yeah, Gomez, yeah, maybe he's okay now, but
it's
that one situation when the referee has to make the call. Remember that no standing eight count. You have to make a decision right there. You're the referee. And I think it's a... nothing wrong with the call.
If you're a fighter at this level and you're getting pummeled seven, eight, nine times without throwing anything back, you got to take a knee. You're already going to lose the round. But it's your only hope to stand in. Now the fight's over, and there's nothing he can do about it.
We'll see if he even had time to take that knee.
I started counting the punches because I had the feeling it might be the end. Go ahead, Dave.
There you go. Gomez misses. Beginning of the end, that uppercut I talked about. Then the right hand on the temple. And now, hey, Gomez is in trouble here. He's getting hit on the temple. All these legitimate shots. Look at him teeing off. Another one right there. Referee steps in.
As the referee was stepping in, Dave, he was landing his 13th unanswered punch. But there are two very heavy, three very heavy right hands.
Most important thing is you watch this as far as the referee's tools. No standing eight count. If there is, that's where you would issue one. But you don't have that, so the referee has to decide, do I do it nothing or is this fight over? And he makes the right decision. Because look, now you've got this young gun teeing off. Every one of these shots is better than anything he threw up until that point.
Now, I have no qualms about what Wayne Hedgepeth did. I think he stopped the fight and certainly used all his knowledge to do that. And those punches, we could see clearly, were heavy, heavy blows.
That's what makes him so dangerous. You know, you think he's in a boxing match, and then he turns it on you.
Well, I was just about to say, or I had said, that I was just waiting for him to explode. And you said that it can happen at any time. And when it happens fast. And that's exactly what happened in the fight. So a brilliant defense of his title for the second time. Saul Alvarez in a six-round TKO victory over Alfonso Gomez.
Yeah, you said at some stage and boom, you were about to say, at some stage, he's got to open up. And he did right at that moment.
Right at that moment. I know he couldn't hear me. Very popular champion, Saul Alvarez. We'll wait and still get the official particulars from Joe.
From the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California, 2 minutes, 36 seconds, round number six. Referee Wayne Hedgebeth calls a halt to the bout for your winner by KO victory and still the undefeated WBC Super Welterweight Champion of the World, Saul Canelo Alvarez.
Canelo Alvarez retains his supremacy in the WBC with a super welterweight championship victory at 154 pounds.